Assalamu alaikum dear friends, I am Sajid Ali. Today's our topic, formation of Muslim League, how Muslim League was formed and why, what were reasons behind it. And it was a Muslim political party in subcontinent, and it was the single political party which started Pakistan movement. And dear friends, it was formed in 30 December 1906. So dear friends, in my last lecture we discussed about Shimla deputation, it was a group of Muslim leaders, 35 Muslim leaders who gathered and went to Viceroy of India Lord Minto for their demands for the rights of Muslims in India. So dear friends, in their demands, one of the major demands, it was the separate electorate. They demanded separate electorate from British India. So dear friends, when Lord Minto accepted their demands, and they Lord Minto answered them positively, that's why they realized a need for political party for the Muslims of South Asia, Muslims of India. That's why they gathered in a meeting of All India Mohammedan Educational Conference. It was 27th meeting of All India Mohammedan Educational Conference, where they discussed about the political party for Muslims of India. And dear friends, All India Mohammedan Educational Conference was a platform, was an organization which was made by Sir Syed Ahmed Khan, as I already discussed with you in my lecture of Sir Syed Ahmed Khan. So when they discussed Muslims about the political party for Muslims, it was discussed in 27th meeting of All India Mohammedan Educational Conference. They decided to form a political party. It was the Muslim League, All India Muslim League, its complete name, All India Muslim League. So dear friends, first of all, main figures, Nawab Salimullah. Nawab Salimullah, who presented a proposal for the party in a meeting, he also suggested to make a political party for Muslims. That's why after making the All India Muslim League, Hindu press criticized this organization, this party, and said it a Salimullah Khan party, because he, Salimullah Khan, presented a proposal for the formation of All India Muslim League. So dear friends, he was Salimullah Khan. And Waqar ul Mulk, who presided the meeting where Salimullah Khan presented a proposal, he presided. He presided over the meeting. Liaquat Ali Khan was also the main figure. He became secretary of All India Muslim League from 1936 to 1947. So dear friends, Qaid Azam Mohammad Ali Jinnah, who was a major and greatest personality in the history of Pakistan movement, freedom movement. So he joined All India Muslim League in 1913, because some Muslim major leaders invited him, such as Maulana Muhammad Ali Johar and other great leaders. So dear friends, the main objectives of this political party is under. At first, to protect rights of Muslims in India. Second, all Muslims should be loyal towards British, because at that time the government of British in India, that's why they had to be loyal towards government if they wanted to get their rights, political rights, economic, social and religious rights. That's why they should be loyal towards government. It was the British government in India. It was the second objective of All India Muslim League. Third, to maintain relations with other organizations were also in India, such as Congress, All India National Congress, Hindu Mahasabha, and other different social and political and religious organizations in India. So the third objective of All India Muslim League was to maintain relations with all other political parties as well as other organizations, whether religious, social and other organizations. These are objectives of Muslim League. So dear friends, structure. What was structure of Muslim League? First of all, president. The first president was Sir Aga Khan. Who became the first president from 1908 to 1919. And after him, other presidents also continued this seat. Joint secretaries. Who were joint secretaries of All India Muslim League? Waqar ul Mulk, and Mohsin ul Mulk. They became the joint secretaries of All India Muslim League at first. Constitution. To make a constitution for a party, for Muslim League, 60 members under the leadership of Maulana Muhammad Ali Johar. Muhammad Ali Johar. 60 members formed its constitution, the constitution of All India Muslim League. It is called Green Book officially. The Green Book is a constitution of All India Muslim League, which was formed 60 members of Muslim League under the leadership of Maulana Muhammad Ali Johar. So dear friends, its office at first was established in Aligarh. In this way, we discussed structure of All India Muslim League. Provincial leagues. When All India Muslim League was formed, it was also decided that in all provinces of subcontinent, it should be formed. So at first, it was formed in Bombay and Dakhan in 1908. 1889 in two provinces, Bombay and Dakhan. In Pune, 1907, a branch of Muslim League was formed. In Punjab, 1907, under the leadership of Mian Muhammad Shafi. London branch. Why London branch was formed? Because London was ahead and a British government in India. India was the colony of UK, United Kingdom, British. That's why Muslims realized it is the great dire need for the formation of a branch in London. So dear friends, in London it was formed in 1908 under the leadership of Sayyid Amir Ali. So dear friends, in this way provincial leagues, provincial Muslim League, its branches were also formed under the leadership of different leaders. In this way we discussed formation of All India Muslim League. And dear friends, this is only political party which was behind the creation of Pakistan. And this is a most important political party, and this was only political party which was in the whole Pakistan movement, freedom movement. Before Muslim League, there was no any political party. So dear friends, in this way we discussed about the Muslim League and its formation, structure, provincial leagues and major leaders and so on. So dear friends, inshallah we will discuss in my next lecture other topics of freedom movement. Thank you very much. Take care. Allah Hafiz.